students, let's continue chapter 1, that is development. In the first two sessions we have done, different people have different developmental goals and people have even conflicting goals. Not only different people have different goals, these goals are conflicting too. Now the next topic, third topic is people look at mix of goals. Mix of goals means more than one. Mix of goals means more than one. At a time, people look not only for one goal, more than one goal. I am giving you one example. Suppose a person has received an appointment letter of job. Job at a faraway place. Job at a faraway place. Before joining that job, the person will consider what things. First thing is income or salary. Obviously, if he is getting more salary, then he would prefer to join that job. Not only more salary, there are certain other things which he would consider. If the person will be able to receive more salary, higher salary, but his family members are not allowed to carry with him, kids are not allowed, then the person would hesitate to join that job. So that's why people look at a mix of goals, like income is the main criteria that they will consider. Apart from income, they will think about their family environment. Is it safe? Then their job is secure in the future. Then equal treatment, freedom, etc. So it means people look at a mix of goals. Not only the higher income, they consider all these things which are equally important as income. Now the next topic is when different people have different developmental goals. These goals are conflicting also. Then on what criteria we compare different states, different regions and different countries. So next topic is, that is comparison of different countries or states. Now different people have different developmental goals. These goals are conflicting also. These goals consist more than one goal. So on what basis we can say that this country is a developed country, this country is a underdeveloped country, and this country is a developing country. There are three types of countries: developed countries like Canada, America, underdeveloped countries like Sri Lanka and Nepal, developing countries like Pakistan, India. Now, to give these ranks to different countries, World Bank is an international organization which gives these ranks to the different countries. Now, World Bank gives rank on the basis of their average income. Average income or per capita income is the same thing. Average income or per capita income. Now, average income, suppose one child is having five subjects. Robin has 5 subjects and the marks in science, Hindi, English, maths and social science. In science he has got 60, in Hindi he has got 40, in English he has got 70, in maths he has got 30 and here he has got 50. These are the marks in different subjects. To find out Robin's average marks, we will add these marks. That is 6 plus 4, 10, 17, 20, 25.
overall marks, that is 250 divided by number of subjects, that is 5, then average marks is 50. Now, this 50 marks is an average figure. It does not mean that he has got in all the subjects 50 marks. English, he has got 70, that is more than average. In science, he has got 60, that is more than average. In Hindi and maths, he has got 40 and 30, that is less than average. So, to calculate per capita income or average income, there is a formula, that is national income divided by population of the country. When we will divide the national income of the country divided by the total population, we will get per capita income. On the basis of per capita income, World Bank gives ranks to the countries developed, underdeveloped and developing countries. In your NCERT books, as per 2013, data is given and it is measured in USA dollars. The countries which are receiving, which are not receiving, the countries which is per capita income in USA dollar is 12,000 something is given. Whose income is more than that, they are called developed countries. And whose income is less than that, they are called underdeveloped countries. And India comes in the category of developing.